Hello, everybody!
Hey, people of the interwebs, I'm Tom.
And I'm Randy.
And that's Ratchet.
And, come on.
And that's Clank!
Yeah!
And we're here with Ratchet and Clank,
Tools of Destruction.
Yeah, that one.
One of the few games that actually doesn't have an innuendo in the title.
I was about to say that, like, up your arsenal.
Going commando. Full frontal assault.
Oh, man. I remember when I was, like, 8, my brother got... No, I was, like, 7. My brother got up your arsenal. And I would go around saying that to people. Be like, my mom would tell me something to do, and I'd be like, up your arsenal! And she just looks at me like... What did you say to me? I mean, I don't think she knows that arse is an insult in England. I don't think she thinks English people exist.
Well, have you ever been to England?
No.
Have you ever met anybody who's been to England?
On Tumblr? it could all be some grand,
So how can you know that England actually exists?
Yeah, it's a conspiracy, man. So, wait, okay, so...
We're going to go save Captain Quark because he's in trouble.
Because he's a fucking piece of shit.
He's the worst hero ever.
He's better than Tidus. I would rather Captain Quark be coming to save me than Tidus, in all honesty. Or Tidus, whatever the fuck you want to call him.
Well, at least he'd be less annoying.
Who, Quark or Tidus?
Quark. Tidus might be more useful, but... I'd rather have, even if he is a giant, braggy piece of shit, I'd rather have Quark around.
Isn't there a side game where you play as Quark?
I think you can play as Quark in All for One, which is multiplayer. But I've also heard it's a shit game.
We should go out just for fun. Alright, this is nostalgia. Oh, man.
Why is there... Oh, I'm gonna have to deal with just my wrench for a little while, aren't I?
Oh, you're gonna have to wrench it up. Alright, let's... This looks
like... Oh, I do have a gun!
Oh, well, okay. Do you have all your guns?
I don't know. Let's see. Normally, to change weapons...
Oh, is it... You murdering sack of shit! Those were frogs!
I do have a couple of weapons. A
combustor and a fusion grenade. Combooster. It's the first one where they start you with a gun.
Yeah, usually you do have to deal with just wrenching it up for a little while.
But who are these frog people? And why are they in my... Why? I'm so confused.
Well, all we know is Quark needs help, and these people are in our way and trying to kill us, so good enough reason for me for now.
That sounds like those lore videos. Like the minute lore things, where it's like, blah 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 blah, here's the lore, have fun!
Are you?
No, he was cute, you bastard! No, he's trembling in fear of your godliness. They probably think we're God.
They should treat me as a god then and leave me alone. Not even sure if I'm going in the right direction to find Quark.
Is there a right direction in these games?
Well, there's usually like multiple missions per level, and so one of them would take me to Quark and the other one would take me somewhere else. Like... I don't know, a obstacle course.
Or Quark's wife.
Well, I don't... If anybody's unlucky enough to be married to Quark...
I always thought it was that, like, Helga lady or whatever from the training course.
Helga and he definitely have a thing going on, but if they actually got married, I don't know.
Thing, marriage, same thing. You're both having... They're both sex. And arguments. And destroyed lives. And sadness. And divorce.
Okay.
And the husband gets left with the children, but not the dog. She takes the dog, but not the kids.
And the car.
She leaves the kids. You have to deal with Bratty, Timmy, and Tommy. You don't get Pussy Destroyer 3000, your lovable cat. I'm trying to convince Megan to name her, the first cat she gets, Pussy Destroyer 3000.
I don't think that's gonna happen, because Megan's not, like, 12. Sometimes she is, but...
She's so 12, when she knows what's actually going on in the innuendo.
Yeah.
Most often she does not. No offense, Megan, we love you.
Not sure if the
no, I don't audio think that picked up.
But Megan said she can hear us already. She is in the like other room, so.
I was trying to think of something witty to say, but I couldn't.
Although
I never can.
Squish.
No.
What are these things? They look like fish or frogs.
Frigs. Frigs.
Yeah. Now officially called frigs. Until told otherwise, they are frigs.
Okay. Let's murder some frigs. Some friggin' frigs.
You friggin' frig.
You frickin' frigs. You'll never be quenched, will you? Have you seen that video?
Nope.
Oh my
Megan
god.
Megan quotes it all the time, but I still haven't seen it.
Just, I don't know what it's called, but it's this dorky little dude in some Sonic backpack, and like, he's defending a Sonic game or something.
Probably Sonic 06.
Yeah, and people were bullying him, and so he's just sitting there screeching in this unholy voice, "When will you learn? When will you learn?" Yeah, like that.
That your actions have consequences!
Yeah, but pitch that up by like 12. Oh.
Apparently we already have some of our old gear.
Yeah, this is weird. Where are they gonna go from here?
Well, we're obviously, eventually we're going to, our weapons will upgrade with enough use.
Well, yeah, but like, is this gonna be like your typical game where we lose everything we have, start from the bottom, like real life? We think things are going well, but then your wife leaves with the kid. No, she leaves the kids. She leaves with the dog. There was a cat. I don't remember anymore. It's been so long since I saw Pussy Destroyer 3000.
That you forgot if he was a cat. Well, I guess it would make sense either way, seeing as if it's a dog, then it eats cats. And if it's a cat, it fucks other cats and destroys their actual pussies.
I didn't know where you were going with that. I was really confused. Oh, man. Freaking frig. Oh my god. Oh, what? It's gonna explode! Oh my god, it's a suicide bomber. I almost made a racist joke.
We should try to avoid those.
Fine. A little.
We have made semi-racist comments in like previous Let's Plays, but...
Innocently racist.
Yeah.
Can you throw your wrench?
Probably, I just need to...
Do you know how to duck? Duck, 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 goose! Oh. Duck, 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 boom!
I'm pretty sure it's just, I have, once you go first person in that, and then throw your wrench.
There's usually like, you can duck and then throw the wrench.
Nope. Oh. There we go.
There we go. Okay, and now wrench it up. Woo! Yeah, boomerang, bitch! I'm your boomerang, bitch. Isn't that a song?
Boomerang, bitch?
Yeah.
If it's a song, I've never heard of it.
I mean, I know there's Bubblegum, bitch.
Okay, that one I haven't heard either.
Oh, it's my jam, yo. Boomerang, bitch by Marinara in the Diamonds.
Marinara? You mean like the sauce?
No, that's not... It's Marina and the Diamonds.
Okay.
Oh my god, you're out of the... And here I thought I was a hipster that didn't listen to mainstream music. Okay, Marina is not mainstream, but a lot of people know her.
Nope, I really only listen to, like, I listen most of my...
90s punk? Blink 182 and, like, freaking...
Hey, Blink 182 actually has a good song out recently.
Really?
Yeah.
That's possible?
Yeah.
After the three times they've broken up.
I don't remember what it's called, but I hear it on the radio all the time when I'm coming home from work. Which is one of the few places I actually listen to music. It's that in Pandora.
Oh, man.
Oh, all boy. Right. Gotta keep running. The path is falling.
What is this? Oh, I know what we need to play for the channel.
No! Oh! What?
Crash Bandicoot.
Oh!
Insane Trilogy.
Yeah, when the new one comes out.
Oh, be prepared, you guys. If this video gets 2 views, we're gonna play Crash Bandicoot. Insane Trilogy.
Well, we'll probably play it either way, but it just depends on whether it'll be on channel or off.
Hey, if you comment on this video, we'll write down your comment, and in 3 months when we play Crash Bandicoot, we'll give you a shout out and call you really mean names. And yeah.
Well, it won't be the kind of shout out most people want.
No, we'll make fun of your name.
Don't fall off, don't fall off, don't fall off.
You probably will, almost did. Alright, don't, okay, oh, whoa, hey, oh, yo, what?
I clipped the ground!
What?
What?
Those. Well, at least it's giving me experience for my weapons.
Way to be positive, Randy. Way to be, look at the bright side of this alien invasion. Isn't this how, like, four of the games start?
I'm pretty sure this is how every one of the games starts.
Oh. Isn't that how Star Wars starts?
Which one?
All of them. Your little city boy off with his wrench, working on a robot, and then boom, aliens! And
oh
then
no!
Boom.
I'm out of that type of gun. Move! Move, you fool!
Move, bitch! Get out the way! Get out the way, bitch! Get out the way! Oh man, this is much more chaotic than I remember the games being this early on.
Yeah, because most of the games don't throw you into a full-on alien invasion. It's usually you're like, murder some frogs and...
Well, we have been murdering frogs. Frigs.
Frigs. Not frogs.
Yay, grenades!
Oh. I'm gonna die again.
You better not. I don't know what I'd do without you. I'd probably finish the game, because I'm invested.
After just like 30 seconds?
Not at all. I have no clue what's going on.
We'll find out.
That's my problem. For a while, I was playing games simply to finish them. Simply to... I had a list of games I wanted to play, or I owned and had to play, and I'd just check them off the list. That's the whole reason I played them.
That sounds boring.
It was awful! Because I got into this awful, shitty mindset with games. And I've been playing this new game... Well, not new, it's like a year old, called the Technomancer. And it's literally like someone took Knights of the Old Republic and tried to create a Dark Souls gameplay, and it just sucks. And I'm still playing it! I don't know if I'm interested or I just don't want to give up on another game. When there's like five other games. Like every Final Fantasy, besides 1, 2, 3, and 4.
Which one of those did you actually manage to finish, though?
None. I've played 1, 2, 3, and 4, and I haven't beaten any of them. I'm on the final boss on three of those. Two, I just quit.
Two sucks. Well, the story, I don't know, because I never got far enough.
The story is actually really good. They, compared to one and three, it's like a genuinely good story. Well,
the only problem is the mechanics are just rough on you.
The story is okay. It's like blah, 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 evil empire, blah, 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 he kills people, blah, blah, blah. But the characters are genuinely interesting. But, sadly, the game itself sucks dick.
Gameplay can make or break a game, but the story is what's most important in my opinion.
And that's, like, this Technomancer game, there's no real story. Like, it feels like an MMO. Ugh. Speaking of which, I really want to play an MMO. If you guys have any fun MMOs that are free to play, and I can play on a shitty computer, let me know. Because I'm dying to play them, even though I don't have time.
Which is why you couldn't play Terra, because you have a... Also, because that massive download.
Yeah, oh my god, you give me a heart attack. Don't do that, Randy. It's not worth 2 bits.
But 2 bits.
2 bits out of 13-something fucking thousand.
Well, it's not like I'd lose my 13,000. This isn't Dark Souls.
Run
away!
Oh my god, this is just...
This is...
intense.
They really dropped you into it.
Dropped you into a flaming pile of shit. Just kidding, it's... I'm being pessimistic. Oh man.
Must keep running. Quark will have the answers. That's not something I thought I'd ever say.
No! It'll all become clear when you see the quark. What is a quark?
A quark is the smallest particle of matter. It's actually smaller than, like, subatomic particles.
I get it, because his dick's small.
Woo! Yeah!
We're literally, like, 15 minutes into the game and we've already leveled up.
Leveled up a gun once.
Oh, how many levels do they have?
Generally 5.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought it was only one. Well, in the first
one. The first game only had... I can't see a thing.
Oh! No! This shit!
I don't
like this.
Oh good, my...
Oh my god.
Oh, it's a good thing we're actually using this controller, because the other two cheap knockoffs I have don't have the 6-axis.
What would have it done?
It would have just been like, yeah, you can't control anything. Have fun hitting everything on your way down. Or just hit one thing and die, probably.
Yeah. That would have been fun.
Oh.
We would have had to just keep starting over and hope there's a break in traffic.
Or I would have had to switch controllers.
Or just run into traffic like I do.
Yeah, but so in the first game, there was only one level.
Yeah.
It upgraded and then you had mods, I think. But in the
I don't
later...
think it was that advanced. I think it was just you level them up once.
And in the later games, there's five levels and the fifth level, like, seriously changes it.
Oh, so the fifth is like the second.
Yeah, right. Okay. So like, in I know you had a... Your starting weapon in one of the games was just like... An automatic pistol. And when it got to level 5, it became two automatic pistols.
Oh. Oh, man.
The frigs are...
Friggin' frigs. You fucking frigs.
Oh.
What
is this, Crash Bandicoot?
Seriously. It's making me really want to play it. I've never played the first Crash Bandicoot. I've only ever played two.
Oh. Not even three?
No, two.
Just two.
Two and, like, I think it was five?
I never
PS2 one.
I never played any of the ones for after 3 because...
Well, that's after Naughty Dog sold it.
Yeah, that's why I stopped playing because it just looked ridiculous.
It did.
And then it got worse and
worse. I don't really like how Crash looks.
In the newest game?
Yeah, he looks...
They did change up his look. They made it closer to the original, but it's still not exactly the same.
Yeah, it's essentially if you take him and put him in HD, and I don't like how that looks... But no, I've only played two. I've beaten it 4 times in my lifetime.
That's more than I think I've beaten most games.
Okay, beat is a rough term. Like, I played through it when I was like 8 and got pretty close to the end, and then I bought it again when I was like 12. Beat it, bought it when I was like 18, beat it, and I bought it when I was like this year, and I got bored and I just sold it back. Which is good, because now we have the future.
Hi, April!
Hi, April! Smaprel, Vinapril.
Vapril?
Oh, God! Megan, please Photoshop a picture of April vaping and put it on screen. Or we'll just force April to vape and then put it on, take a picture, put it on. Oh my God, funny story time. Okay, so when I was working at 7-Eleven, this really flamboyantly dressed dude, he was like almost metrosexually dressed, he comes in, he walks up to the front, and the first thing he says is, "Do you vape?" And I instantly, like, I have to turn around and laugh. Like, I could not take him seriously. And so he's trying to find vape liquid, and he's like, "What's your highest quality vape liquid I can buy here?"
This is just, fucking 7-Eleven,
I look him dead in the eyes, and I'm like, "You got shit and more shit. I don't even vape, and I know that." And he looks at me and is like, "Well, that's dumb, because I'm here, and I'm out of vape liquid, and I need a vape. There's a smoke shop not even 2 minutes away, you fucko." Like, literally, you could walk there!
He probably came from the other direction, so he didn't see it yet.
Well, no, then he was like, "Well, I'm here already, okay?" Well, so I totally missed exposition.
Emperor wants to rule the world. End of story.
Oh my God, okay.
You know.
What is this, Final Fantasy?
Although his name's Percival, so we're making fun of him for that.
Oh. Penisful.
I will grab this Wii U.
Are you playing Breath of the Wild yourself?
Maybe!
Well, there is a lot of things we should probably do off camera, like foraging and...
Yeah.
For raging.
And cooking, because...
Megan says she hates it. Well, not that she hates it, but
no,
it's not
good. It's a good game, but it's not a good Zelda game. That's what she said.
That's from what I've seen, yeah.
It's very much like Skyrim, except...
I mean, but if you take it to its base elements, it's a lot like the original Legend of Zelda.
Yeah.
They went one direction with the rest of the Zelda games, and they kind of had, like, a little niche.
Okay.
And so they're just trying to break from the niche, I think, to, like,
the
Zelda. Yeah, niche.
Yeah, but there are some cool things in it, like, all the different armors and weapons.
I'm in love with it. Like, I don't know if it's my favorite Zelda game, but it's my favorite game.
Okay.
Like, it's amazing. It deserves all of the 10 out of 10s that it's got.
From what I've seen, at first it seemed like it'd just be another Ubisoft kind of Assassin's Creed. Here's a waypoint, here's a waypoint. You all get waypoints! kind of game.
Well, there are a lot of waypoints, and they are very far apart.
Yeah.
But it's okay.
As long as there's story. Okay, so we died. Do you need help?
No.
Do you need a doctor? Do you need a child's physician?
I always need a doctor.
Do you need CPR?
All right.
Bye. What?
That? These aren't fricks. Okay, so bye, everybody.
Bye.